Joe Biden made a speech in Nevada and told Trump, you're not going to destroy me. Yeah. Then Biden was like, I'm letting Elizabeth Warren do that instead.
Senator Kamala Harris is featured on the new cover of Time magazine. Not to be outdone, Joe Biden is featured on the new cover of Don't Touch.
Beto O'Rourke just posted an Instagram video of himself getting a flu shot. It's the first time since the campaign started that we can honestly say Beto's got a shot.
The New York Times has published an article about the advanced age of the top three Democratic candidates entitled, Is Age Only a Number, Even When You're Running for President? And this can't be a good sign. All three cut out the article to read later.
The people close to Trump are worried that he's becoming more and more unglued. At this point, the only glued parts of Trump are his teeth and his hair.
President, as you may know, he tweeted out a Nickelback meme yesterday. Because apparently that's what presidents do nowadays. Well, overnight, Twitter took down the tweet after receiving a copyright complaint. Nickelback versus Donald Trump. No matter who wins, we all lose.
It's not a good sign for Trump when even Nickelback is like, we can't be associated with you.
I never would have guessed that when Donald Trump finally did face serious legal consequences for his actions, it would come from Nickelback.
Likewise, China should start an investigation into the Bidens. Because what happened in China is just about as bad as what happened with Ukraine.
Trump turned to his staffers like, are you losers happy I didn't say it over the phone this time?
That's like if Jeffrey Dahmer showed up in court wearing an apron that said, kiss the cook.
That's like chugging a beer while taking a breathalyzer test.
President Trump today publicly suggested that both Ukraine and China should investigate the Biden family. Oh, what happened to doing your crimes in private?
Again with the son. Donald Trump has paid more attention to Joe Biden's son this week than he has to Donald Jr. and Eric their whole lives.
He tweeted in all caps, election interference. That wasn't a complaint. It was just accidentally tweeted his to-do list. It was like, my bad, that was supposed to be a DM to Ukraine, China, Australia, and Russia.
Trump once publicly called on Russia to investigate Hillary Clinton. Then he asked for Ukraine's help with the Bidens. Now he's asking China. You've got to admit it, in his own way, Trump really does bring the world together.